Hello students, welcome to the online session of Basic Electronics. I am Ami Patel. In this video, I am going to discuss one more biasing circuit, that is the emitter feedback biasing circuit. In the previous video of this chapter, we had discussed different BJT biasing circuit that includes fixed bias circuit. Next, we had seen the collector feedback bias circuit. Then we had seen the voltage divider bias circuit. And now, this is the last one, that is the emitter feedback bias circuit. So let us begin. These are the contents I'm going to discuss in this particular video. So first we will see the emitter feedback bias circuit diagram, and then we will do the DC analysis of this emitter feedback bias circuit, and in that we will find out the quiescent point coordinates, and at last we will see how the stabilization of Q point is achieved in this emitter feedback bias circuit diagram. So let us see the circuit diagram. This is the circuit for emitter feedback bias, and you can see this is just like the fixed bias or based bias circuit. The only difference is we have included this emitter resistance. So this is why this is also referred as the modified fixed bias circuit, because the fixed bias circuit diagram is modified and we have just added this emitter resistance between this emitter terminal and the ground. So this is also referred as the modified fixed bias circuit or base bias circuit. And as we have connected this RE, that is why it is called the emitter feedback bias circuit. So let us do the analysis. DC analysis of emitter feedback bias circuit, and for that the circuit diagram is drawn again. And as you already know now, if you have watched the previous video, then how to do the DC analysis, and for that we are finding first base current by applying KVL in the base loop. Then we will calculate IC, that is from the equation IC is equal to beta IB, because IB we have already calculated, and at last we will apply KVL in the collector loop and we will calculate the VCE. And this is how we will find the coordinates of quiescent point. So let us begin. To calculate the IB, let us apply KVL in base loop. Now base loop will be over here, that is from VCC through RB through this base to emitter junction to the ground. So let us write the equation for this: VCC minus IB into RB, that is a voltage difference across this RB, minus VBE, that is base to emitter voltage, this is VBE, minus IE into RE. This is equal to 0. Now we want to find out actually base current. Well, we have one part, that is IE into RE. So we will replace this IE with IB plus IC. This you already know. And we also know that IC is equal to beta IB. So we can write this IE is equal to IB plus beta IB. So we will write this into this equation. So we will have next equation, that is VCC minus IB RB minus this VBE minus, we will write IB plus beta IB into RE is equal to 0. Now we will make this IB as the subject. So we will just move this IB terms to the right hand side, so it will become positive, and we will rewrite this equation as IB is equal to VCC minus VBE. Just rearranging the equation, we will have this RB plus 1 plus beta RE. So this is the equation for the base current. So that is this, and this we can write as IBQ, that is a quiescent value of the base current. Now we will calculate the equation for IC, that IC is equal to beta IB, and the value of IB we had already calculated in the previous slide, that was VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus 1 plus beta into RE. So this equation we already have. We will just put this value of IB into this equation. So IC is equal to beta DC. Over here we will consider all beta DC because we are doing the DC analysis, into VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus 1 plus beta DC into RE. So this is how we can find out ICQ. This is one of the coordinate of quiescent point. Now we will calculate the collector to emitter voltage for this emitter feedback bias circuit, and for that we will apply KVL in collector loop. I'm not drawing this collector loop again. I'm just showing it in this main circuit only. We will start from this VCC until ground. This path we will follow to apply the KVL. So I will write the equation of KVL: VCC minus IC into RC, that is a drop across this, minus the drop across this collector and emitter terminal, VCE, minus drop across this RE, that is IE into RE. This is equal to 0. We have already calculated IC over here. That is why we will not just replace anything with the IC, because IC we had already calculated in the previous slide. I will write IE is equal to IC plus IB in this particular equation, and rewrite this equation: VCC minus ICRC minus VCE minus IC plus IB into RE is equal to 0. And I will write VCE as a subject, then the rearranging equation: VCC minus ICRC minus ICRE minus IBRE. Now over here this base current IB is very small, so we can write that RE into IB, this drop is very small, which is very less as compared to the VCC. So we can just neglect it. We will neglect this and we will rewrite this equation, that VCE is equal to VCC minus RC plus RE. Just take IC common, and this is the equation for VCEQ, that is a quiescent point coordinate. And this is how we can calculate the VCEQ. Now we will see how the Q point stabilization is achieved over here. So first, due to variation in the temperature, the IC increases, and due to change in the beta also, if increase in the IC takes place, then what happens? Due to increase in the IC, IE will also increase, because we have equation IE is equal to IB plus IC, and due to increase in the IE, the voltage drop across this resistor RE, because at emitter we have one resistor, that is RE over here, and as this emitter current increases, the voltage drop across this RE is going to increase. That is why we can say this VE increases. As VE increases, VB is constant over here, the base voltage is constant, then we can say this VBE, this is increasing, this is constant, that means VBE, that is equal to VB minus VE. As VE increases, VBE decreases. VBE decreases, that means the base current which is entering through the base terminal is going to decrease. And due to decrease in the base current, we know equation IC is equal to beta IB. IB decreases, IC also decreases. And the compensation for the increase in the IC due to rise in the temperature is achieved. So whatever increase in the IC takes place due to increase in the temperature is compensated due to the design circuit diagram, and respective decrease in the collector current is achieved. With this, I am ending this session over here. Thank you.